Good Monday, everybody. The 20th of July, 2020. My name is Jewel, and we're going to check out everything tropical weather-wise right now. Now, as we see, we have three lined up here. In my general forecast this morning, I said there would be two. There was two at that time. Now the third one has popped up, and I'm telling you now it's looking like maybe four or five will pop up as they come off the coast of Africa. As these we are looking at right now, this is the disturbance number one area that showed up yesterday. It's still disorganized with showers and thunderstorms over the Bahamas, the central eastern section of Cuba, and the adjacent Atlantic waters. It's all associated. It's still just a tropical wave. It's not a low pressure system. It's just a tropical wave. Now, it is expected to move west-northwestward through the Straits of Florida today, over the southeastern Gulf of Mexico by tomorrow, and across the central Gulf by Wednesday, and reach northwestern Gulf Coast by Thursday. It's looking like it could be a little more conducive for development once it reaches into the Gulf of Mexico. We are going to have to watch this system. Great. As of right now, 10% in 2 days, 20% in 5 days. We're just going to have to watch it. Remember, folks, all of this can change in the blink of an eye. Disturbance number two. Shower activity. It's just a tropical wave. It's located about 1,000 miles west-southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands, and it's become a little better organized in the morning hours of today. The conditions are expected to be marginally conducive for development of the system during the next few days while it moves westward at 10 to 15 miles per hour over the tropical Atlantic. By Friday and over the weekend, conditions are forecast to become less favorable for tropical cyclone formation. Now, 2 days, it has a 20% chance. 5 days, 20% chance. Now we have disturbance number three. The surface observations indicate that a weak low pressure area has formed over northwestern Gulf of Mexico. Now these showers and thunderstorms are currently disorganized at this time, and little or additional development is expected before the system moves inland over Texas tonight or tomorrow. It's going to hit land. It's not going to have time, hopefully, to progress upward in cyclonic action. Now, it's 10% both for 2 days and 5 days. And I'm going to show you all of this stuff. And folks, I'm telling you, two more coming off. I'm going to show you them. And why or why not they may or may not develop. But lots of rain is going to come up in the Florida Straits and over the Bahamas today. And in portions of Texas and Louisiana, this disturbance number three is going to bring you a lot of rain. Now, when we go over to the eastern Pacific, we have 7E right here. It is a tropical depression now. The winds are 35 miles per hour. Located 18.0 north, 129.3 west. It's moving northwest at 12 miles per hour. And it is a tropical depression, but it should come post-tropical in a few days, and I'll show you. Here, disturbance number one. This is a low-pressure system. It's about 850 miles southwest of the southern tip of Baja California Peninsula. It is continuing to show signs of organization, and the recent satellite diverted wind data indicate that the low is producing winds just below tropical storm force. Now, the environmental conditions are conducive for development of this system, and a tropical depression or tropical storm is likely to form in the next day or two. It's moving slow west-southwestward and then westward around 10 to 15 miles per hour. 2 days, 70% chance, and in 5 days, a 90% chance. And for 7E out in the Pacific, you can see it is a depression right now. It turned that way last evening, but by tonight it should become post-tropical, and it is moving down this way. It should be post-tropical, just bringing thunder showers, maybe some gusty winds in this area. As we look at the surface map for tropical weather right quickly here, we can see we do have this tropical wave here, here. We got another one over here. We got another one over here. We're going to have two more come off, folks. I'm just telling you, right below the monsoon trough, okay? Now, this low that's formed up here, or this tropical wave, it's very weak going into Texas, as you can see. It does have a few gusty winds, nothing too severe, it doesn't look like at this time. But you are going to be getting some rain and some gusty winds from it. And down around Florida, when this tropical wave does move through and out of the Bahamas, you are going to have some gusty winds also. Nothing awful bad, but you are going to have some winds, and you're going to have some rain. Now, when we look at the satellite view as of now, this is what it's looking like. We've got some shear wind going on, but where these little tropical waves are starting out, as you can see where they are, they're all coming off down in the monsoon trough. There is a little dry air, Saharan dust mixed in with this. We still have some more coming down, but there's a huge high pressure up here, as you saw on the map a while ago. Now, as we come over to the infrared area here, you can see all of these cloud tops. Here is the system out here, and I know all you folks over here are sitting on pins and needles, but just hold on, okay? Over here's a system that's over Cuba and the Bahamas right now, and here's this little system with the cloud tops. Don't look too bad. We'll go to the infrared plus. You can see over here, right in here, moving up into Texas, you are going to have, and this affects a little bit of Louisiana, you are going to have some pretty good rain showers come down with some bad storms in it as this approaches your coastline. Over the Bahamas and the Florida Straits, you're going to have thunderstorms with a few gusty winds in it. We're going to see what happens when this moves along day by day, and I'm going to show you the other two systems as they come off. Now, you can see a little better on this. This is the European model. I've checked other models. I'm just going to show you this one, though. I like this one. Yes, I do favor it, but you have to check them all, folks. But this is going to give you an idea of what's going on, okay? And I will keep you informed. Do not worry. So I'm going to turn it on. You can see the timestamp down here. And as it progresses along, this is what's happening as of now. As of now, in the Gulf of Mexico, it's a surface trough. It's analyzed in the Northwest Gulf, and it's contributing to scattered moderate showers and isolated thunderstorms. Now, it's looking like the scattered moderate convection is over the far eastern Bay of Campeche in association with this feature, and general moderate winds will prevail across the Gulf waters. Now, it's looking like it's going to move into southeast Gulf Coast tomorrow and then move westward across the sea in that area. And it should have a pressure gradient between the high pressure north of the area and a low pressure over Colombia. And it will maintain fresh to strong trade winds over the south central Caribbean this week. Expect increasing winds and seas east of this area Tuesday night through Friday night as a high pressure builds across the western Atlantic. Now, for the Atlantic Ocean, here we go. We have a broad upper level trough that's extending over the southwest North Atlantic, Bahamas, and Florida Straits. The northern extent of the tropical wave is also moving through the region, extending northward across eastern Cuba and the western Bahamas. Now, these features have scattered to moderate showers, isolated thunderstorms over the Florida Straits, Old Bahama Channel, and across the Bahamas. Now, locally, along the Antilles and most of the Bahamas, it's looking like strong east winds are noted along the north coast of Hispaniola, extending out farther east, and there are several surface troughs containing isolated showers. Now, when we get to Bermuda, we have a high. It's centered east of Bermuda, and that ridge will result to light gentle winds found in the area of 26 north to 32 north, and then we have a high pressure. This high pressure ridge north of the area is going to support fresh to strong winds off of Hispaniola and near the entrance to the Windward Passage for the next several nights. And it's looking like currently along 76 west, it's going to move westward, and the winds and seas will increase east of 65 west tomorrow night through Friday night as the high pressure builds across the western Atlantic. Now, this moved through, but I am going to turn on the pressure gradient mode right quickly. If we can come on here, here we go. You can see, let's back this up to around Monday. Okay, we have this one here. It's got a little bit of vorticity in it, but we have this huge high pressure, folks. Look at this thing, would you? Look how big this high pressure system is. Now remember, right up in here is where most of the Saharan dust is, right? Well, this high pressure is bringing it over this way. Now, if these fellas could make it past the Saharan dust and the sheer wind that's going to be coming in with the other systems as they move out, leaving it behind, some of these could develop. I'm not saying they are. I don't think they will at this time. But you can see the timestamp down here. This is at 3 a.m. Monday. It is a low pressure system now. We'll move it up to around 4 p.m. Monday. Still looking like, you know, these showers haven't got into it yet. If they did, it would be bad news. But it's got all these scattered showers in it. We'll move up to Tuesday around 4 a.m. in the morning. Still there, but not bad winds in it at all. But some heavy, heavy rain, as you can see. We'll blow this up just a little bit here. You can see this heavy rain. This is heavy rain right out in this area. As we move along to Tuesday evening around 10 p.m., it tries to get a little better organized. It tries to get a little better organized. The wind in it, I do not think, is bad at all. You can see these are the sustained winds into the north quadrant of it. The winds are only 27 miles per hour. That's what it's looking like today. It could be changed by this afternoon or tonight. Now, the gust in this little system right here at this time, 41 miles per hour. So that's tropical storm force winds in this little system by Tuesday night. Like I say, we'll have to watch these very closely. And we'll move on up to around 10 a.m. Wednesday. And then we have this one. This one's out here. It'll probably form Tuesday night, maybe Wednesday morning. But we have this low pressure out here. Now, when it's a tropical wave, yes, it can develop. If it's a low pressure and it's in this tropical environment, it has a better chance of developing. So here we go. But we have this high, remember, and this Saharan dust. We're going to have some sheer winds. I don't know if these little fellows will make it or not. We'll move on up as far as we can get to around 6 p.m. Wednesday afternoon. This one is still here. Doesn't look like it's going to do as much. But this one, I really, really don't know what it will do. Let's bring this back to size for a moment so we can see everything as we move across. Both of these are moving in the direction of the islands over here. I will keep my eyes on them. If they do get past the islands, this is an if they do get past the islands and get in the Caribbean and get on up and follow this line right down in here and then get up in the Gulf, they may form over if they do dissipate. As of now, this is what it's looking like, though. I wanted especially everybody out in this area that's my subscribers and over in the Bahamas and Cuba and also in Texas. This one's going to bring rain coming up real soon for you guys and gusty winds, and over in the southern Florida and Florida Straits area. But these two, which are not on the map yet, I really wanted to bring to your attention. We've got to watch all of them, folks, because they all could do something. We don't know if they are or not yet. We'll have to wait and see. If this dust moves on out, excuse me, and if the winds are died down with sheer winds, they could turn into something. So we'll have to just wait and see on that. But so far as the systems right now, the ones that are showing up from the National Hurricane Center, you can see where they are right now. 3, 10% chance we'll watch it. 1, 20% chance in 5 days we'll watch it. This one, 20% chance also. These are the three that the National Hurricane Center have up as of now. Thanks for watching, folks. Please remember to subscribe, click that bell, and check off all to ensure you get all the latest in tropical weather and weather in general, with watches and warnings and any type of weather that you need to know about. If it's important and it looks like it's going to get rough, I'm going to put it up for you. I love you all. Thank you so much for watching once again. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you, and may each of you have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Remember, I'm going to keep my eyes on these systems. It's hurricane season. I hope everybody up and down the East Coast have their kits, their plans, and everything prepared, because hurricane season is really going to kick off, I think, probably next month, and we know September. Stay safe, my friends. Thanks for watching.